Hello, I'm ApiX Toycat, and have you heard? They added frogs to Minecraft today. This is pretty significant by itself, and of course I want to talk about all the ramifications of them having a brand new beta or snapshot for 1.19 already just 2 weeks into the Caves and Cliffs update, but first, let's go find an actual frog, shall we? So as you can see, frogs have in fact been added to Minecraft. They've got very big pink heads, they look suspiciously like pigs, some would say, but no, this is actually a frog. They spawn in the swamp. Okay, I can't make this joke. As you can see, this is in fact a frog. It is a brand new mob that spawns exclusively in the swamp biomes, and they've already given it three very unique, very adorable animations. This is the walking animation, which I love. There is also a croaking animation, which you're soon to see, and of course there's an ability to jump. The frog basically switches back and forth between these three things, and I know immediately alarm bells should be ringing in your head. Oh no, what have they done? Have they made another useless mob in Minecraft that just passively sits there in a biome, adding to the long list? And no, don't worry, this is actually already sounding like a pretty interesting mob, because not only is it very adorable, which to some people is enough for a mob to exist, don't get me wrong, perfectly appreciate that if that's your opinion, you know, people think all sorts of wrong things all the time, but also here's the other thing: if we go into the water and we grab some of this seagrass, which does require shears as a fun fact, you can actually feed the guys and then they will love you. As you can see, just like every other mob in Minecraft, they will come towards you with your seagrass, and this means that if you have two frogs together, I think I saw one just over here, then what you can do is, of course, you can breed the two of them together. Will they get close enough to each other in that time? I genuinely don't know. They're very slow walkers, as you can see, but there's something very fun that happens when you do manage to get two frogs to breed, and it's not just a tinier frog, although actually, wouldn't that be adorable too? Frogs are one of the most unique mobs that exist in Minecraft, because unlike every other mob, when they mate, they don't immediately just like offshoot some babies. I mean, one of them jumps away. He is done with that mating procedure. But instead, what they do is they eventually give birth to some tadpoles somewhere around. I don't know which one of them is going to give birth to the tadpoles. I guess we'll find out, won't we? So apparently they were meant to have given birth to a egg of some form. But I don't see an egg around here. I do see an animal capable of producing such an egg, though. You know what? Let's give it a try. Okay, this is the only logical way, right? We have to take the animal that we know makes eggs and give it to the animal with the animal that we know can also do so. And we just gotta get them close enough together. This has not worked. Okay. What about you? Can you? Where are my eggs? That was a very good synchronized jump. I've got to hand it to them. Okay, let's do take two. Here is one frog. Here is a second. Okay, here's just three frogs, I guess. We'll give them all some stuff. Wait, are they gonna? There we go. Look at this. And then you get some experience. And then they make a little frog egg. Apparently, I don't see a frog egg. I just see a lot of sadness and rejection here. So the only real precedent we have for a mob like this, where just breeding it isn't enough, there are also other conditions that need to be met once the breeding has taken place, is the turtle, which only gives birth on beaches. So obviously the logical next plan is to breed a couple of frogs together. Okay, this one's already been bred, which means he's got a ton of babies in him, and then we bring him to the beach. Or this is the closest thing we have to a beach, okay? It's a swamp biome, what can you expect? And so using this together, we hopefully should end up with our frog babies that we are owed, I would like to point out. I feel like a needy grandmother who's asking for grandchildren at this point, but on the other hand, it looks like that works. Here are some tadpole eggs, some frog eggs. Can you stand on them? Will that break them? Oh, you can go through them. Oh, that is very interesting. As you can see right here, this is me standing inside of the frog eggs. Are you meant to be able to do that? I mean, I can only assume so. Pretty cool stuff, right? And then the frogs can also float. Oh, and there we go, it's that fast. That is all it takes for some tadpoles to be born. That is actually quite amazing. So now, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna grab ourselves our water bucket right here, because as you all know, one of the most important items in Minecraft is the bucket. And we're gonna try and scoop up a tadpole, because here's the great thing about tadpoles, right? Wow, look at that. Tadpole got him. But as we saw at Minecon Live, there are actually three different types of frogs that will exist in Minecraft. There is the regular swamp frog that we just saw right there, and then there is a type of frog that will exist if you grow up your tadpoles in a cold biome. Also, just as a horrific fact, if you want to be cruel like this, you can take one of your buckets of tadpoles and you can drop them down right here. And if the, okay, well that's gonna cause me some issues. If the tadpole ends up on land, he kind of flops around like a fish and then eventually suffocates. advocates. Is this what you should be doing? No, but I mean, is trapping villagers inside of a house what you should be doing? Probably also no, that's a human rights abuse, but we're still doing it anyway. Anyway, so if you stay here long enough, eventually the tadpoles grow up.
1 eternity later.
The frog didn't grow up, but a polar bear spawned, so that's kind of progress. So yeah, it takes some time if you want to grow one of these fellas up, it seems. That's not even your child, man. You didn't have him a few seconds ago. You can't be mad at me for this. Okay, fine. We'll do this the boring way, Minecraft. Fine, if you really prefer it this way. Here you can see that when a frog spawns in a frosty biome, he spawns an entirely different shape. Also, here's a fun fact about them, because I said earlier, they're not an entirely useless mob. I hate when people say, oh, they're not useless because you can breed them together. No, that's not a use, that's just a self-sufficiency method. So, as you can see, frogs do exist, and also, the cool thing they do, get this right, is they attack slimes. As well as fireflies, which they're of course gonna eat, slut frogs will attack slimes and turn them straight into slime balls. This is really, really cool in my opinion. Obviously, it's not so great when it comes to the giant slimes. I'm not sure there's any easy way for them to be attacked by frogs. Actually, let's find out. You know, also, this is very funny to watch. But let's go ahead here and see what happens when we take 3 frogs. And as you can see, they only go for the little ones right now. But yeah, we have a natural predator to the slime finally, which is pretty adorable to look at. I think they need to attack the big slimes too. I think we need someone to take down big slime. Sadly, it's not the frogs. So yeah, the third variant of the frog is found in desert biomes. I mean, you can argue that actually this is a desert biome because it doesn't rain here, because it snows. But I think we can ignore that point for now. Just for fun, here is a reminder of how much biome matters. On the right here is a frog naturally spawning. I mean, actually, this one naturally spawned. But here is a frog being spawned in the snowy kind of tundra biome. And on the left, here is a plains biome spawning a more orange frog. Which means that, as you can see, orange, green. Orange, green. Orange, green. It's very fun to look at, actually. Anyway, so there's one more frog I have to show you, which involves finding a desert not covered in snow. Although now I'm interested, does extreme hills count as snowy? No, it counts as plains slash swampy. Every biome has one of the 3 variants, snow, desert, or I guess neither of those two, which is the easiest way to distinguish all 3 biomes, I guess. What about savanna biomes? Oh, savanna biomes count as desert. As you can see, on the right here, we have the plains frog. On the left, we have the savanna frog. Or the desert frog. As you can see, white actually looks pretty good on them. It's not the cutest of colors, but I see why that exists. So as well as being able to take out slimes, which is a very minor ability if we're being entirely honest, they're going to have some other use. They implied that at Minecon Live, they implied it here. As well as their food type being uncertain, we also don't know about what their intended eventual use is. For now, they're being added to this beta so that we can check them out. And honestly, now's a good time to talk about this beta, right? Because isn't it so weird that you're seeing a 1.19 feature, a very fully fledged one with the frogs, with full animation support and everything. Like, this is a full 1.19 feature that they've just thrown out here for us to play around with in the middle of December, 16 days after the 1.18 update rolled out. In fact, it's even more confusing because it's only for Bedrock right now, alongside all of the other sculpt blocks, which if you don't know, there are lots of sculpt blocks which exist exclusively in Bedrock. These features have been rolled out to Bedrock first, which is very, very interesting in my opinion. I mean, but by itself, it shows that they're clearly actually committing to support Bedrock and betas rather than have it be the second fiddle, and as it has been in certain parity decisions. But the other thing that's interesting here is that clearly they are getting straight onto work with 1.19. There is always this downtime that Mojang has between updates, you know, between when 1.16 came out and when we started seeing Caves and Cliffs, there was months. And in those months, we're assured they're working on things. But like, you know, without the snapshot process, it's harder to see what that actually means on a week-by-week basis. But as you can see right here, in the last 2 weeks alone, they have worked on a brand new mob. They've worked it into the game code. They've given it behaviors. They've given it things that it wants. In this case, seagrass, as you can see. They've given it breeding behaviors and animations that aren't normal because, again, they have to go find water if they want to give birth to their little tadpoles. It is very unique, very interesting to see that they've made this happen. And honestly, this gets me excited for 1.19. And allow me to explain what I explain why. And honestly, one of the cruxes of this video, because I am genuinely very, very, very excited about what this means. Because again, unlike before, we usually have this big multiple month long gap between one update and the next. You could argue it's crunch. You could argue it's just, you know, like, without a deadline, who's accountable? Who knows for sure which it is? But the point here is that this time we're seeing direct work on 1.19 now. We're seeing the warden in screenshots. We're seeing the frogs being played around with in these Bedrock betas. And that gives us a good idea that they actually do either want to get this update out early next year, or potentially even better, if this is coming out in the second half of 2022, imagine how much time and, you know, effort and work it will have by then. It's hard to be certain, but for now, what I can say with absolute certainty is that these are some adorable mobs. I'm glad to see them in my Minecraft. I hope you all enjoyed this video where we check them out for the first time. Let me know if you like this slightly different style of beta video, and if you want to maybe see more of them, because I think it's fun. And you know what? The only thing more fun than this video is the fact that it does in fact have to come to an end. If you want to see, I've been doing a lot of this recently. I've been working on my Deep Dark project live, because I figured my next survival project I would do as kind of like a show off as much of it as I can live, get some recordings done. So if you want to come check it out, feel free to come along to come over to this channel. So before you leap into the next video, I hope that you consider perhaps subscribing to the channel over here so that you can see more of these videos every single day on your homepage. Oh, the frog eggs are all bursting. Oh, that is beautiful. You know what? I hope you'll enjoy it, because I'll see you next time. There are so many tadpoles here. What is happening? Goodbye. Oh yeah, they're one of the first mobs to give birth to multiple offspring. That's a cool behavior too, right? That is very fun.